So as a mobile game developer, I sometimes use systems like Apple's Game Center to allow people to do things like share high scores, track achievements, even challenge other players. Now, if you're not signed in to Game Center, you may find some functionality in some games that you download don't work on your iPhone and iPad. It's fairly easy to sign into Game Center. Assuming, of course, in settings you're already signed into your Apple ID with your iCloud account and everything like that, Game Center is just basically a toggle switch to turn on. You can scroll down and find Game Center down in the section that includes like music, TV, photos, etc. You can see there's a Game Center option there. Go into that and you can see on this iPhone it's turned off right now. So to turn it on, just flip the switch and it's going to ask you if you want to set it up. So you can hit continue and then it's going to ask you to authenticate with your Apple ID password. Now you're all set and it shows you that you're using this account for Game Center. The one option here is the nearby players option. Sometimes with Game Center you can do things like other people in your household on the same Wi-Fi network or with a Bluetooth range you can play games. And there's also a Game Center profile. Now this is what a lot of people are looking for sometimes in settings. They'll notice that they have a name when it comes to Game Center for the high scoreboards, for challenges and things like that. And they want to know if they can change it. Sometimes a lot of people think it's strange. It's not the same as the name they're using, saying for iTunes reviews or in other places. But it is different and this is where you change it. You just go right here and you could set it to whatever you want. Now it's going to go and check to see whether or not that name is available. So each name is going to be unique. So we'll just leave it at that for now instead of me searching for one. You've got the option to remove all Game Center friends. People can you know, set up friend relationships on Game Center and that way you can challenge your friends. You can just remove them all and kind of start from scratch. A future version of iOS is going to allow you to go and see the list and edit it. So you'll have that feature as well. Now there is the possibility that you may want to use a Game Center account that isn't your Apple ID. For instance, say you have an iPad that's yours and you have children at home and you want them to each have their own Game Center ID. So you have an Apple ID for them set up with very simple settings and you want them to be able to switch back and forth with who's playing and whose high score will be recorded. You can do this. At the bottom here you can tap on Use Different Apple ID for Game Center and then you can tap on the Not option and sign in with a different Apple ID and this Apple ID will just be used for Game Center. It won't change the Apple ID being used for everything else, iCloud, iTunes, etc. So you do have that option to be able to have a separate ID for Game Center than you do for everything else. So that's the basics there. That's all it takes to do it. One thing I will say though is this was more true in the past than it is now, but sometimes when Game Center isn't working, like you're trying to submit a high score or an achievement and you're getting a Game Center error message or something like that, the easiest way to fix that is to simply go here and turn off Game Center and then turn it back on again. In the past that fixed tons of problems. It doesn't seem like I'm getting that many people having problems with Game Center nowadays. So things are a bit more stable. But if you do run into a problem with Game Center, the first thing to do is just turn it off and turn it back on in settings and that seems to take care of it in most cases.